see it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to True Crime Banter, the podcast aimed at bringing you your dose of murder relaxation. So, sit back, relax, and enjoy the episode. Skate rink. What up? Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode, another microdose from the True Crime Banter podcast. And we were just talking about the chicken dance because I was doing the chicken dance to the intro song. And you brought up the point that you only do that really at like a
the skating rink. Yeah. Or sometimes if you're at a lame wedding and they play it.
True.
Sorry, but
that and what's the hokey pokey? That's the other one that they do at the wow. Bring back some elementary school memories. Good times. As our dog going crazy over there, Mr. McGeets. Well, hero everybody. And welcome. My name is Ping, and we're going to get this thing started. This will be a nice, quick, short little microdose, hence microdose. And I'm actually going to start off with some shout-outs.
Okay.
Two shout-outs, per se. The first one is, and this is a quick, nice little reminder for everybody, that you can go to Apple Podcasts and leave a review, leave a comment. You can also go on Spotify and leave a review. No comments yet, though, so hopefully those are coming soon.
Hopefully.
This one is on Apple Podcasts. It is highly recommend by TaylorMore19.
Ooh,
and Taylor says, love this podcast. It's also so sweet how they engage with their listeners.
Aww.
So, Taylor, thank you for letting us engage with you.
Yeah,
and
thanks,
thank you for engaging
Tay-Tay.
With us as well.
Yeah.
And then the second shout out I have is, she's going to come up, and I know this is a girl.
Okay.
She's going to come up again later in the podcast because this is Kaylin Ray, and she left a review also on Apple Podcasts saying, love, I listen to every episode as they come out, becoming one of my favorite true crime podcasts. It's cool to listen to a couple go back and forth, a couple as in us. You can
couple
feel,
of idiots
I read that
kind of
weird.
Yeah.
You can feel that they're having fun creating this together.
Aww.
I especially love that they cover cases I've never heard of, and sometimes they focus on cases in my home state, which are always fascinating. So,
cool.
Kaylin Ray, thank you for that review as well.
I have a couple real quick.
Oh, okay.
When you said that, I forgot that I have some.
All right.
So, the Nicolette, right? She's an OG.
Oh, yeah.
She said, yay, I'm so glad you did this one. That's it. And I'm like, oh, thank you.
Shout out to you, Nicolette.
So that is our last episode that she's referring to, the Erber Baumeister
nice,
one, which if you guys haven't heard, go listen. It's interesting, creepy, gross, freaky, all the good stuff that
Erber
you like.
The pervert.
Mm-hmm. And then somebody named Miss_Hell_33 said, just followed the show. This episode looks so good. Then Vivian Star _, she's another one that we've shouted out for.
Mm-hmm.
She said, I loved this one with 12 Vs. This podcast does such a good job finding unique cases that haven't been podcasted about 3, 9, 10, 12, 10 times.
Oh, so
never,
she just wrote a big number.
A bunch of numbers, yeah. Yeah. Never get rid of the banter. As you said, it's in your title. If people don't like it, fuck them.
I like it. I love it.
Yeah, I know,
actually.
Right?
Actually. Well, thank you. Thank you for that. I 100% agree with her, by the way.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Nice.
Yay.
Well, you've got a story that you want to cover for today.
Oh, yeah. I wanted to do kind of like a little funny one.
Okay.
Am I going first?
Yeah. Because I've got a little, or you know what? I'll go first.
Okay.
So I just mentioned in the Apple Podcast reviews that Kaylin Ray left this review.
Okay.
5-star review. Awesome. Thank you. And if you guys want to be shouted out,
best.
Definitely
cool.
go on Apple Podcasts. Leave a review. I'm going to read them all. Good, bad, indifferent. I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah.
But the thing is, Kaylin is also my sister. So,
dun, dun, dun.
So this is a conflict of interest, maybe. But we've mentioned her in the past, and we have, I guess, like a group chat together called the Murderinos, where we'll talk about random weird things here and there every once in a while. And a few weeks ago, actually, this is probably a couple months ago now, she brought up a good question that I thought, you know what, we should talk about that on Microdose.
Okay.
So
okay.
Here we are.
Here we are.
She said she likes true crime and she listens to it for entertainment. But she wonders if people who do this all day, every day for work, do we think that it is difficult for them to have, I guess, to live a normal lifestyle?
Hmm.
So she said, you know, if she was a CSI or a crime scene investigator, would she be able to live a similar life to what she's living now? Or would it affect her maybe mentally or emotionally in a way that would drastically change her lifestyle? So I wanted to see what your thoughts were on this.
I mean, I don't mean this in the rudest way ever, but no fucking duh. Like, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely, of course. There's not even a question. You hear it from these fucking forensic files and people that talk about cases and stuff all the time.
Yeah.
That's, how can it not? There's people that talk about cases that happened 20, 30, 40 years ago.
That still
when they
is
were
affecting
rookies,
them.
That still, yeah. That you know, whether it's like some kid got murdered and you walked in on it or whatever and you had to do it, or I don't know, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
or you having to be the one that tells the parents that they found their kid dead, or like all the little terrible aspects of it, or being there when a family member IDs somebody's body. Like, there's so many, it's not just the crime scene part. There's so many different things.
I agree.
You might not be the one cleaning up all the blood, but you're going to be fucked up some way or another.
Yeah, and obviously, like you said, no offense, but fucking obviously it's going to be a completely different lifestyle.
Yeah.
And so you kind of brought up the fact that like there's small details that you don't hear about in like true crime cases, and like you said, talking to the families,
all the
having
behind
to,
the scenes stuff, yeah.
And that kind of the moment you said that, it made me think of Detective Joe Kenda,
Lieutenant.
There you go. Okay, so what is that show that he's?
Oh God, I can't remember.
We'll
but he's got
to,
books out too, and so I'll look it up while you're
it's,
talking.
It's crazy because this lieutenant used to be a detective, I think, in, like, the Colorado area.
Yep.
He has so many small details that he remembers from cases, like, 25 to 30 years ago. And it's the smallest little thing that you're like, why would you even remember that?
It's called Homicide Hunter.
Yes, there you go.
He's got a bunch of little spinoffs, too, and stuff, and he's got books out.
Yeah, and that's the main one where they kind of reenact big cases that he's solved, or small cases.
Yeah.
It's also, that's the thing, though. Even the smallest cases, he can remember and pull back.
And you know what, really quick, going off about that show real quick, it's, I think that was you I was watching it with, or maybe I thought about this to myself, but he's got so many episodes, and all of these are, like,
crazy.
You would think one of these would happen in your lifetime as a cop, but I'm like, there's no fucking way these all happened
now, granted,
to this one dude. But he's been in this force for like a million years. He looks like a dinosaur.
As a TV show, you know, it is a dramatization. So they do, I don't want to say they play up, because these are like homicides.
No, but you can't make up some of the stuff. That's not like allowed. Yeah. But sure, you can have the people be like a little more dramatic in the like reenactments and stuff. But like, you can't make up the fact that they were shot 80 times or in the face or whatever it is. Like, that had to have happened.
No fucking way. So, highly recommend
watching
that if you're into true crime, which you probably are. If you're,
I don't really love reenactments, but if you're fine with it, go for it.
Yeah, and I'm not a big fan either.
Acting's
but for some
not
reason,
the
this.
Best, but.
Yeah. That show is pretty good. So, I just wanted to pose that question because I think a lot of us, we've talked about this in the past. Sometimes you like to look up, like, the crime scene.
Oh, yeah.
Especially if it's, like, kind of gruesome.
For sure.
Yeah. Which is a lot more than some people who like true crime will do. You know, it's
some of them just like to listen. Yep. And even if it gets a little too much, they're like, I got to turn it off. And,
but when you actually see this stuff, you know, that adds a level of exposure that you eventually grow, I guess, accustomed to or numb to.
Yeah.
Like, you still understand the reality and how affected these families are from these scenes, but you you don't like start to feel it as much yourself. You're like, whoa, this is fucking, I mean, it's, you feel it,
no,
but it
I
changes,
agree.
You know,
no,
it's
I agree.
Fluid, I guess. I don't think that ever happens when you actually work in the field.
What?
I don't think, like, I don't think you get accustomed. I mean, I think you get accustomed to like blood and gore, I guess.
Yeah.
But going into a case.
Yeah.
Like you're talking about with police officers or crime scene investigators, when you don't know what you're expecting and you walk in and you see, I just heard a story about a decapitated like 6-year-old.
Oh my God.
Like you don't expect that kind
Ugh.
Of stuff. Or even just
no.
You know, a beaten 6-year-old that might be crying.
Right, like, right, right.
These aren't things that you're like, oh, this is just normal.
Yeah.
Which, you know.
Well, shit, I can't even imagine. Like there's some times when I'm on friggin' TikTok. And you already know this is going to be
oh,
good
God.
When I say that. But
oh,
there's like, you know, everybody these days has their phones out recording everything. The second something mm-hmm. happens, there's
it's
a phone.
Everywhere.
And
yep.
even when you're watching it from that person's point of view in the background, there's 30 people on their phones recording it too. Like
yeah.
you just, it's everybody's instinct. Some people do it for like legal reasons. If they're getting in a fight, they want it recorded. Okay,
mm-hmm.
cool. Or if they're getting pulled over, whatever. But there was one where this woman and her friends or something were driving, and there was a little, like, 2-year-old boy who was, like, about to walk into traffic, and I guess they stopped him. This part wasn't recorded, but it when it started recording was when they had called the police, and the police had just pulled up, and they were with this little boy, and they were, like, holding him, and he's in diapers. He's in a diaper, and
okay.
he has, like, a shirt that he's holding or something like that. So he's totally naked, basically. And they're, like, somewhere warm. You can tell, like, Arizona or something. And they're by a main road, and they're showing where they saw him walking, and they're telling the cops, and this part's all on the film or whatever. And they're like, yeah, he was about to walk over there, and it just shows, like, a highway. And they're like, he was on the sidewalk of this highway, and we just saw him and just, like, got out of our car and ran over
yeah,
real quick.
Yeah. Hey, buddy.
And they're walking around, and there's nobody outside looking for their kid. There's nobody anything. And finally, he's just sitting in the car, and you can see him. He looks so fucking scared.
Yeah.
Like, he was like, I don't know any of these people. What's going on? There's... He can tell people are making a fuss over him, you know? And then the ambulance shows up to, like, check him out, make sure he's okay. And one of them is a female. And he instantly grabs her and, like, puts his head in her neck. And, like,
right.
just that's the first sign that you see him being, like, comforted, kind of. Like, okay, there's a woman kind of thing. And everybody's walking around, like, where the fuck is your mom or your dad or anything? You don't hear anybody yelling for their kid or
Did they
anything.
Ever...
And I don't know. They show him walking. There's, like, apartment complexes nearby. And they show, like, these ambulance people walking, like, holding him, like, trying to find their mom or something. And I'm just bawling
of
the
course,
entire
yes.
time. Like, this poor little kid.
Yeah, that
and
is...
And that's just a TikTok.
And that's a...
And he's clearly okay.
Yeah,
you know?
I was gonna say,
I can't
that's
even
a
imagine
good story,
a murder
that, like,
in front
this,
of me
yeah.
of a kid or... Like, I just could never, which
yeah.
is why a lot of people can't do that job. Or when they do, they walk away with PTSD, a drinking problem, a divorce, or, you know, something. There's
yeah.
always something that accompanies that.
Yeah, there's something about, I think, humans in general. You saying that made me think, you know what, that's if you're that EMT probably or paramedic, you're probably going to remember the story about
yep.
the little boy that, you know, immediately grasped onto you
yeah.
because you were the only one that he felt
exactly.
comfortable with. And that's like I guess a good feeling.
Yeah.
You know, that's good to know, like, you can help
yeah.
someone in need.
Right.
And I have a lot of memories from past jobs where it's like, I remember the good things.
Yeah.
But humans are more predisposed to, like, remember terrible things. I feel
right.
Like, if you look at, you know, Instagram comments or you hear it all the time, like, public figures. It's like, oh.
Yeah.
Everyone can say, you're great, you're doing awesome. But the one person that says, you look fat.
Yeah.
You're me. That's what you hold on to.
Yeah.
You know, or, you know, us, you sound dumb or I hate
yeah.
the banter, and it's like, oh, like,
don't worry,
like
I don't
she
hold
said,
on to
fuck
that
em.
Don't worry.
Yeah, but humans are, I think, feel like
yeah
predisposed to holding on to the negative stuff. So imagine your job in the police force, crime scene investigations, that's all negative. Like
yeah.
there's never good stuff when you're being called out to a
right?
crime scene.
Thank God for therapists, man.
Yeah,
I mean
yeah.
even that's not like for sure gonna help you, but you
yeah,
know
I couldn't imagine. So
yeah,
well, to answer the question, yeah, I think life would change drastically.
Yeah,
if we
so
actually lived
I'm
it.
Good I'm gonna stick to making coffee and talking about murder. So
cool, I'm just gonna
cool.
stick to making murder and talking about coffee.
Okay, anyway.
Anyway, you have a story.
Yeah, this is a short little one before my phone dies. Let me get this
thank
in here
goodness
real quick.
And then surprise surprise for everyone, we got a 5-second songs.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So this. Okay. Oh, sorry.
Oh no, you're no, you're fine. I guess you can talk now.
Take the lead here. This happened back in 2018, so it's not anything. But the title grabbed me, which I won't read it because then you won't want to hear the story. It's the exact same thing. But it says, Kansas City, Missouri, a man whose excessive flatulence forced a police detective to cut short an interrogation has pleaded guilty to a federal gun and drug charges. The Kansas City Star reports that 25-year-old Sean Sykes Jr. entered the plea on Monday. The charges stem from a police traffic stop in September in which officers found a backpack with drugs and guns. Sykes was a passenger in the vehicle. A detective reported that when he asked for his address, Sykes, quote, leaned to one side of the chair and released a loud fart before answering, end quote. Court documents say that Sykes, quote, continued to be flatulent, end quote. And the detective was forced to quickly end the interview. Then it says he was sentenced after that.
Wow.
So
the tactic.
If anybody needs to get out of an interrogation, just keep farting.
Interesting.
Apparently it works. That's, and like, they give up right away.
That's like a when you're trying to beat like a lie detector or a polygraph test, to like clench your butthole, I think.
I've
is like
never
a,
heard of
really?
That.
Really? Because it
you would.
I don't know. I remember this is from I like 10 you. Years ago.
10 minutes
and
ago.
It does something to your heart rate or something. Like instantly. Yeah. Don't ask me. I've never had to take a polygraph test.
But I have had to clench my butthole.
Yes, that's what it sounds like. Daily, by the way. That's what it sounds like though. Is like one of these weird tactics. Like, here's how you get away with an interrogation.
There's probably somebody out there just writing and bullshit stuff so that when people get arrested they're just like hope
look
to see it in the
stupid.
News
that, yeah, this, and they all live in Florida. Yeah. I can only assume. Oh wow, interesting. Okay. So that was 2018 and he got charged after. Okay. Yeah. Wow.
anyway
why don't we move on to a little 5-second songs, because it's been a while since we did the last one.
Hell yeah.
And these songs, I've got 4 songs for you to decipher.
Okay.
I suppose. And they are 4 of the top songs from 2007.
I wouldn't have drank that much if I didn't know we were gonna do this, but maybe it'll make me better. Who knows?
Okay. All right, so here is your first edge. You know, I should probably make sure
scream it out when I know
it. Yeah, so just I guess scream it out and then I will play, you know, a portion of the song. So you can, I guess, fall back into some nostalgia.
Cool.
Again, top songs from 2007.
2007, freshman year. Okay. T-Pain, Bartender, right?
Okay, all right. Okay. Who else was in that? Do you know?
T-Pain, Akon?
Oh, nice.
Did I get it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, cool.
Good job.
It just felt right.
Yeah. Well, I thought that I would start you off with a pretty chill, good one.
Okay.
You might actually get all of these. Who knows? Okay. I gotta start getting a little more aggressive with you. But here's song number 2.
Like we always do with this time. Oh, is this Flashing Lights Kanye?
Ooh, almost, but not
quite. Oh, wait.
Quite.
It's Kanye, though.
It is.
Hold on, let me think. Ooh.
What's the song, though? People are like, oh, come on.
I know.
You got this.
I... Dude, that's so long ago. T-Pain.
Uh-huh.
Superstar or something? No, or
almost.
Like,
it is Good Life.
Good Life, damn it. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Almost. All right, so you're at 50%. Okay. Wow. Gotcha.
So far, we'll see.
All right, and here's another one. Again, top songs from 2007.
Okay. Okay, Neo.
Damn, you got that.
I know
quick.
It's Neo. Like that, uh-huh. The artist really never baffles me. It's these stupid titles they choose, and I'm like, I don't know, dude. They're all the same. Fuck.
Can she do it, ladies and gentlemen? She's thinking. Let the alcohol fuel the
That's
nostalgia.
Not it. Oh, I don't know. Fucking tell me. Because of you.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Okay,
whatever. There's like 8 million songs in the world that are named that.
That is true.
You know what, Neo? Get your shit together. Choose something cooler.
All right, here's the last one. I don't know if you're going to get this one. I think you're going to get the song name. I don't think you're going to get the artist.
Okay.
Ready? The last one for the day.
Da-na-na-na-na-na.
What?
What is that? Stop it, drop it low, da-da-da-da-da, something.
Okay.
Yeah, come on. Play,
you're on
play
to
it. I know.
What is it,
drop
though?
It, little mama, shake your flowers on the something, isn't it? Come on. Yeah. Pop, lock, and drop it.
Bye.
You're right. By somebody who only ever got famous because of this song.
Huey.
Yeah, see, okay.
Goodness so gracious.
Huey, where the fuck have you been, Huey?
He's been popping and locking and dropping it.
At home by himself.
Yes. To a lot of money.
He's been quarantining since 2007. That's why we haven't heard of him.
Okay. All right. Well, I think you failed.
I think
we all win though, because that was
I feel
fun.
Like I should get little half points, right? Just like they on the morning talk show thing.
Sure.
I get a point for the artist and half a point for thinking really hard about what the title.
So I think you just got 100%. Congratulations.
Nailed it.
Well, there awesome. You go, everybody. Cool. Welcome to the True Crime Banter podcast.
Yep.
That was a lot of banter. And Mr. Tito over there is trying to join in on this outro. So there you go. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, go to Apple Podcasts. Leave a review if you feel fancy.
Yeah.
And if you're feeling not so fancy, go to Spotify and also leave a review.
Yeah, just wherever. Beggars can't be choosers. Just leave something nice wherever you want.
Yeah, if you got a question like Kaylin sent us that we could, kind of talk back and forth. Our dog. What is he doing over there?
He's having a moment.
Well,
just let him work
through
it.
All right. Well, again, if you guys have a suggestion for a microdose topic that you want to hear us talk about, feel free to follow us and comment on Instagram.
That's our cue to get out of here.
We got Riley.
Cut the lights.
I'm
Cut
Riley. That's Christian. That's Tito in the background. And we will talk to you guys next time.
Bye.
Adios.